Howdy folks, JimRuthless here, and today we're going to start a new series of outfits here on the channel. And the plan is to do a few legendary gunslinger and legendary outlaw outfits. And what I mean by that is that we're going to recreate outfits of real gunfighters of the Old West. And in this first video, we're going to recreate some of the good guys, aka the gunslingers. So, let's jump straight into the video folks. And the first outfit we're going to recreate today will be Pat Garrett's outfit. And Pat Garrett was a legendary lawman. He was the sheriff of Lincoln County, New Mexico, and he became renowned for the killing of Billy the Kid, the most famous outlaw of the Old West. And Pat Garrett was gunned down and killed in 1908, and his murderer was actually never caught. So let's see if we can recreate the look of this legendary lawman, and we can start with the shirt here. And let's go with a white striped everyday shirt, and then we can go with the striped everyman jacket in black, and let's find some matching pants, the padded saddle work pants, and then we can go with a pair of black gaiters, and let's go with a black Bulger gun belt, and then we can go with a red puff tie, and then we need the black and red short stovepipe top hat. Let's add a grey paisley vest. And here we have Pat Garrett and his outfit. And since all of these photos will be in black and white, I will use color sometimes to spice up the outfit a bit, like I did with the puff tie here. And Pat Garrett, he also wrote a book about Billy the Kid called The Authentic Life of Billy the Kid. And I haven't read it, but I would sure like to, since it was written by someone who actually met Billy the Kid, and eventually killed him too. And there's been countless of movies about Pat Garrett. James Coburn played him in the 1974 western Pat Garrett and Billy the Kid. And then we had the first Young Guns movie where John Wayne's son, Patrick Wayne, played Pat Garrett. And last year Ethan Hawke played Pat Garrett in the movie The Kid. So, let's leave Pat Garrett now, and next up is Virgil Earp, and he was Wyatt Earp's older brother, and this guy was a marshal down in Tombstone, Arizona. And Virgil Earp became famous for taking part in that legendary gunfight at the OK Corral in 1881, together with his brothers Morgan and Wyatt Earp, and Doc Holliday was there on their side as well. But later on, some outlaw retaliated and gunned down Virgil Earp. So let's find him an outfit then, and we can start with a white everyday shirt. Let's add some black dress shoes, and then we can go with the black clerk pants, and let's go with a blue worsted coat, and then we can add a black lancer vest, and let's go with a blue dress tie. And we can go with a purple stride hat, just to add some colors. And here we have Virgil Earp. And he must have been around 60 when this photo was taken, because he died at an age of 62 in 1905. And Virgil Earp has also been portrayed in a lot of movies. In 1946, Tim Holt played Virgil Earp in the classic movie My Darling Clementine. And then Michael Madsen portrayed him in the Wyatt Earp biopic from 94. But his most famous portrayal must be from the movie Tombstone from 93, where Sam Elliott plays Virgil Earp. So, let's do another outfit now. And next up we have Sheriff William J. Brady. And like Pat Garrett, William J. Brady also operated in Lincoln County. And Brady was the sheriff in town, and he sided with the Murphy-Dolan faction in the Lincoln County War. And this made him an enemy of Alexander McSween, Billy the Kid, and the Regulators. And the Lincoln County War was a conflict between two factions, and like a lot of conflicts back in the day, they turned violent, and one thing led to another, and eventually Billy the Kid and some of the Regulators ambushed Sheriff Brady and four of his deputies on the main street of Lincoln, which led to William J. Brady's death. And now we're going to try to recreate William's outfit from an old photograph. So let's start by adding the white French dress shirt. And then we can add a black folded string tie. And a black Lancer vest. And then we can add a black roller jacket. And some black cuffed town pants. And let's go with the black gaiters. And the agency gun belt. And here we have Sheriff William J. Brady. And I must say that he was very well dressed. And I'm not sure that he always dressed this good, or if he dressed up a bit for the photo opportunity. Well, now it's time to leave Sheriff Brady, and the next outfit will be Bass Reeves' outfit. And Bass Reeves was born into slavery, and sometime during the Civil War he gained his freedom, and eventually he became the first black deputy US Marshal west of the Mississippi River. And this guy arrested more than 3,000 felons, and he shot and killed 14 people in self-defense. And it's rumored that the tumbleweed sheriff Sam Freeman is loosely based on Bass Reeves. So let's try to put together his outfit then. And we can start with a white everyday overshirt. And then we can go with this checkered Richfield vest. And let's add the brown checkered Everyman jacket. And then we can go with the brown striped studded pants. And let's add some brown gaiters to that. And I think we're going to go with the white Thacker hat. And here we have Bass Reeves, recreated from an old photograph of him. And it is kind of hard to see what type of hat he's wearing in this picture. But I guess the Thacker hat looks alright. Well, it's time to move on again. And next up we have none other than Allan Pinkerton. And you might be able to guess who this guy is upon hearing his name. Because Allan J. Pinkerton, he was a Scottish-American detective and spy, best known for creating the Pinkerton Agency. And at one point, he protected none other than Abraham Lincoln. And if you have played the single-player campaign, you must have met the Pinkertons, because they were a big part of the story mode, of both Red Dead games actually. And you might remember Andrew Milton and Edgar Ross, they were both Pinkerton agents. But in real life, the Pinkerton Agency was a private detective and security agency. And the Pinkertons actually sued Rockstar for portraying them as villains. But I don't remember what happened to that lawsuit, so let's try to recreate Allan Pinkerton's outfit instead. And we can start by grabbing the striped blue everyday overshirt. And then we can add the black duster coat. And let's check the pants. We need some black tuxedo pants. And then we can go with the black workman's boots. And let's modify the outfit and put the boots under the pants. And then we can add the black Gatlinburg hat. And here we have Allan Pinkerton, the guy who founded the Pinkerton Agency. And this is a classic look, I must say. Maybe the duster coat is a little bit long, and we can't close it, but otherwise I think this looks pretty good. I really like the shirt, it looks spot on, but feel free to share your thoughts on these outfits down in the comments below. And let me know what type of outfits I should do in the next episode of Legendary Gunslingers, or Legendary Outlaws for that matter. And have a look at this photo, I think this is so cool. You might recognize the guy to the right, it's Abraham Lincoln standing there next to Allan Pinkerton. And I thought this picture was pretty cool. And well, that's all the outfits I had for you guys today. But if you enjoyed this outfit slash history lesson, then smash that like button. Subscribe if you're new and hit that notification bell. And as always, drop me a follow on Twitch to catch my live streams, or check out any of my other links down in the description below. Because I'm on Instagram, Twitter, Patreon, and Discord if you want to come in contact. And I've also opened up a merch store if you feel like supporting the channel a little extra. So check the links below, folks. And thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys further down the trail. Bye bye.